Okay.
Okay. Just leave that right there and return it.
Ring her off.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Here we go. Wow, I know you're all thinking, you can give me Pavarotti for the show here.
Yes, absolutely.
I've been told that before. I wish I had that voice. Well, first off, welcome to Mojos, Cafe Gallery, Mojos Music Venue. It's an honor to have you. It's an honor to host our tribute, memorial, celebration for our dear friend, family, mother, grandmother, Jeanne Harris, who spent many, many, many hours and nights and here in many days, who helped me start this venue for the youth of Ogden in all ages 9 years ago. We've been doing almost 10 because of Jeanne. We're here. She set that up with her work at the city, and we're one of the success stories of the many, many, many that she helped get started. In the last decade, many of the projects you've seen in this town, she had her hand on and had a big influence in making it happen. And many saw the files and those that worked with her knew exactly what I'm talking about. They had the ideas, and then they passed them to Jeanne to make them happen, and she did. So you see 25th Street, where all the old dirt lot was for 50 years. She was a part of all of that infill. Junction across the street, she was a part of that. And here on the east side, and many young businesses that went to the big for guidance, through SCORE, through her services and all her staff, there's many are here, helped many, and I'm aware of them all, at least most of them, because Jeanne and I are friends from way back, and at least a decade, and we would talk about all these fun, positive, great things happening to our city. And I am happy to say that we are one of her success stories. And if I'm the father of Mojos, which I'm called many times, she's the godmother. And her art hangs here and has for 8 years, her beautiful, beautiful art. She was multi-talented. She had the skills of a brilliant businesswoman when she worked for the city, and she had the skills of a fine artist, and not only in her oil paintings, but also in her words, where she wrote for Street Magazine, a magazine that we had in here for a period of time, and she had the calm of our voice, which she talked about the projects here on this street in the town. So, Karen mentioned the word unsung heroes, and thank you for that. That's what she was and is, because everything she touched will be here forever, or at least a long time, and including people like myself with projects like this that hopefully will survive through the years, way beyond me even, to have a place for the musicians, the artists, the youth, the older youth, the younger youth, everybody, to be able to express themselves. And we've had, in the 8 years, over 1,500 shows right here on this stage. In the early days, it wasn't a stage, it was a flat floor. And Carolyn and all those over here in the early days remember that. And we've evolved through the years, but we've had hundreds of thousands of people through the door, viewing the art and taking in the space. So I don't really need to go into how wonderful Jeanne was, because everybody here knows that. I've gone over all the things I wanted to share in my little segment here over and over again, and had so many things. And I reflected from the first time we met down at the Raven's Nest little cafe. I had a short time that she did help, and she nurtured, but they had partner problems that's beyond anybody's control. And we hung out there, and from there we cultivated an amazing friendship, and one of the best that I've had in my lifetime. And she will be missed very much. So Anyhow, we put together a nice little tribute for her today, tonight. And we thank you so much for being here. She loved you all, you know that. And she touched so many people, and everybody she touched, she saw deep into them who they are, really are, and their potential, and their purpose. And everybody loved her. And whenever she was in here, everybody loved her that I introduced to her. She just greeted everybody so warmly, and they always remembered her. And they would tell me what a classy lady she was, and what a sweet lady, and she just enjoyed every minute. Did she, Carolyn? You were here. Those are memories that I'll keep forever. But anyway, like I said, I promised I'm going to stay and keep it all together. We've had already plenty of times to let loose, and today is the day to show our feelings and to share our thoughts and our emotions, and there's nothing wrong with that. I think we forgot to get tissue. I'll park along this stuff. So you got to use your own shirt sleeve like I will. And I have so many things to say, and right now I can't even think of one beyond the obvious, and who this amazing lady was and how she will be remembered by all of us and many who were not able to make it today. And she made a home here in the last decade in Ogden, Utah. And it's amazing when you look at the story, what she did and how many corners of this city she was a part of, and from the art to the writing to the business she did to just personal projects and the friendships and the loves and I've reflected many times, and it's a long, big story, so you all know this. So my part here is to welcome you and welcome you to Mojos, and to really feel that she's with us. I've been feeling her very strong. It's been less than a week since she left us, and I don't think she's too far, and I think she loves everybody here so much that she wouldn't miss this party, as I think Tina said. This is a party she's not going to miss. And she fought so valiantly this last year, and she's an inspiration for all of us, for me. I know that I've reflected on my life since this whole thing, and I'm seeing things a little different in some ways, and looking at priorities a little differently, and making decisions and judgments, I think, in the future based on her common sense that she had, and her love, and her story. And that's something I will cherish for the rest of my days till I get to see her again. And I know she'll be there. She believed in me, and she believed in all of you in a very special way. So with that, we each got to pick a song that we thought reflected Jeanne to us as we do our little part here. And at some point, I'd like to have you all come up and share. But the song that I've selected is from Marty Proudfit, a local musician who is making it big in Boston right now, and this is off of her CD. She's making another one, and she started right off of this stage. And every time I play this song in the last year, it took me to that place with her, and the words I thought were of her, and words that she would say to me. And I know her daughters, we played it, and they agree that it was pretty special. So anyhow, that's where we'll go. And one last thing, let's all give a toast to Jeanne. To Jeanne. We love you, Jeanne. Thank you.
Yeah.
And you can see it out there on the collage on the top left corner. And it's of her when she was, I think, in high school. And I was in front of her when she was sitting on the couch, and she could, you know, she was not very communicative, but I showed her the picture and I said, "Oh my God, you were a Bond girl. Look at that picture." And she was like, you know, she gave me the same expression. I love that expression. But she always downplayed it, and tonight is my turn to have the last word, and that's why I picked this next song.
Jeanne is digging that song, right?
Yeah.
She had a serious